Good morning. My name is Gary Katzman. I'm an Associate Justice of the Massachusetts Appeals Court. It's a privilege to be here this morning. I am pleased to use my 8 minutes to talk about Discovering Justice, a nonprofit organization dedicated to educating our youth about democracy, and I think it follows from what the Secretary has talked about. John Adams, who Leslie Berlewitz has already quoted, also said that children should be educated and instructed in the principles of freedom. Civic education has languished in recent years in the face of high-stakes testing and increasingly demanding educational requirements. There is also a vast educational achievement gap in our country. The upshot is the vitality of our democracy is called into question because our citizens know so little about it. Studies have shown that only 1 in 7 Americans can identify a justice of the United States Supreme Court, but 2 out of 3 Americans can identify a judge on American Idol. Discovering Justice teaches and inspires underserved youth about democracy, the power and potential each student has, individually and collectively, to effect positive change in their communities, and the importance of pursuing justice throughout their lives. Its mission is to prepare young people to value the justice system, realize the power of their own voices, and embrace civic responsibility by connecting classrooms and courtrooms. It has been my great privilege to have been involved with Discovering Justice for many years as a lawyer coaching young students in mock trials, and in recent years as a presiding judge in various appellate programs, answering questions and talking with student groups who come to our courthouse. And it's often many of these students have negative associations with the justice system. I've also been involved as a member of the Board of Visitors of Discovering Justice. Discovering Justice and the humanities intersect in important, mutually reinforcing ways. By enhancing literacy and the ability to think both verbally and in writing, and by fostering an appreciation of language in history, Discovering Justice promotes the tools that are needed to fully enjoy the humanities. At the same time, Discovering Justice makes use of the humanities in fostering civic education. It is fitting that in one of its first programs, more than 10 years ago, it was featured a courtroom performance of Sojourner Truth, a one-man play about the former slave who became an abolitionist and feminist. Following the performance, the late, great United States District Court Judge, Reginald Lindsay, who grew up in the Jim Crow South, drew parallels for the audience between what they had seen in the play and the history of federal law and civil rights. And Discovering Justice has also worked with theater groups to put on plays for young people. One, for example, was about the Palmer Raids of 1919 and the parallels and the questions that might be drawn to security and civil liberties in the post-9/11 age. It has also sponsored a playwriting competition designed to encourage playwrights to write about justice for young people. Discovering Justice starts in elementary school with a program called Children Discovering Justice, a literary-based social studies curriculum for grades 1 through 5. The 12 to 16 week curriculum engages students in discussions about rules, justice and equality, the rights and responsibilities, and hopes to teach students through readings and discussion principles of democracy, history, judicial education, and civic responsibility. Let me give you just an example of some of the programs in this elementary school initiative. Grade 1, the theme is, what is a rule? Why do we need rules? Who makes the rules? What's a good reason to challenge a rule? Through literature such as Shel Silverstein's Sidewalk Ends, the story of Ruby Bridges by Robert Coles, students develop literacy skills while tackling relevant questions important to their lives, their classrooms, and their society. Grade 2, the focus is justice for all. What is freedom? What is liberty? What is equality? How can an individual work towards justice? The students are taught through reading, discussing, and writing such stories as Honest Abe by Edith Kuhnhart and The Sneetches and Other Stories by Dr. Seuss. Grade three, rights and responsibilities. It delves into the relationship between individual rights and group responsibilities within the context of revolutionary Boston. Texts include Paul Revere's Ride by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, Sleds on Boston Common by Louise Borden, and The Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss. Grade four, the theme is Becoming a Nation. It provides students with opportunities to connect various skills and to ask larger questions about people, to gain an understanding of immigration and how our natural resources contributed to the growth and diversity of our society. Anushka's Voyage by Edith Tarbescu is one of the readings, for example, which is designed to promote greater understanding of immigration. Finally, in grade five, for the elementary program, the theme is the United States Constitution, Solving Problems. The United States Constitution uses the process of writing this founding document to study the various ways groups of people solve problems and examine some of the compromises in the Constitution that were necessary to secure ratification by the 13 states. Discussion questions include, why did 13 colonies need to unite? How do you share power equally? What happens in a solution when a solution doesn't work for everyone, a so-called solution? The main text You Were There When They Signed the Constitution by Elizabeth Levy. Additional texts include The Arabolis of Liberty Street by Sam Swope. Teachers love this curriculum because it combines literacy and social studies and allows, we believe, seamless integration of civics into their test-driven scheduled days. Discovering Justice provides professional development for every teacher, including working sessions about our nation's documents, questions and answer forums with lawyers and judges, and activities that build confidence and enthusiasm to become civic educators. Significantly, Discovering Justice also provides every classroom with the books used in the curriculum, often giving teachers their first new material in years. Finally, as part of the Discovering Justice, one grade per school has a chance to visit a courthouse to engage in age-appropriate mock trials in which they learn about reasoned arguments, yes, even at age six. I was coaching a student, and it was called, the trial was The Theft of the Teddy Bear, and he asked me a question. It was a good question. I tried to answer it, and he looked at me and said, "You really don't know the answer, do you?" Appropriately humbling out of the mouth of Dave. For the middle school, there is also a program, 6th, 7th, and 8th grades. During the school day, Discovering Justice offers a constitutional field trip called Discovering the Bill of Rights. And in the real courtroom, students learn about the First and Fourth Amendment and then develop and present an appellate argument based upon a landmark Supreme Court case. I cannot tell you how thrilling it is to participate in the judging and to see the seriousness of the young people as they appear in our courthouse. And my courthouse is the John Adams Courthouse. I hope you all visit it. It's the wonderfully restored 1894 courthouse. Or, of course, the wonderful Moakley Courthouse, which is very much a community courthouse. Besides discovering the Bill of Rights, there is a 10-week mock trial program. There is an 8-week mock appellate program, Stand Up for Your Rights, which we've also partnered with Camp Harborview. Students talk about, argue cases involving such issues as search and seizure of student lockers, or questions of silent protest wearing armbands, all taken from Supreme Court cases. In this past year, Discovering Justice has reached more than 12,450 students in Boston, Cambridge, Watertown, and the gateway cities of Lowell, New Bedford, and Worcester. It plans to go deeper into each of these cities in the next couple of years and to expand to other cities and hopefully to go nationwide. Discovering Justice's ability to introduce students, particularly students from underserved communities, to the power of words, to an appreciation of good writing, to stimulate an understanding of history and democratic institutions, law and the pursuit of justice, all this at an early age, we hope will lead them on a path toward success, tolerance, and good citizenship. Thank you.